As a longtime member of the Appropriations Committee, former in subcommittee chair, now ranking member, has the Appropriations Committee's power been curtailed in this last round of budget negotiations with the banning of earmarks?
No. And I have to say, and I'm going to be as candid as possible, the appropriators are going to be okay, because we know people in agencies and so on. We will continue to do the best job we can for the country and to some extent for our congressional districts, because that's our job as well. But I feel quite strongly that the writers of the Constitution knew what they were doing when they gave the power of the purse to the Congress. Ironically, what the other party, the Republican Party, has said, and of course, obviously, President Obama is going to agree, let's give all that power to the president. Let's let the president get earmarks. I was a budget officer in the late 60s and early 70s. Every dollar is earmarked. It's just a question of who does the earmarking. It seems to me that everyone would be far better off if the Congress took back its appropriate role and distributed those funds in a way that it thinks is in the best interests of the country, and then let the executive branch weigh in so that you have some balance. Now we're giving all that power over to the executive branch, and obviously President Obama thinks it's a great thing. He's going to veto every bill now that has any kind of earmark. Well, you know, that may work for a Democrat while the Democrat is in the White House, but things change, and I don't think it's healthy. Now, as an appropriator, we're going to be okay, but I don't think that the country is best served by this attitude about earmarks and about spending in areas that where most people have no real idea about the benefits of particular programs. They just see a title, they see a dollar amount, and they decide, let's cut it by 50%, 80%. That's no way to run a government.